of doubt, is there?
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Be seated if you'd like. Appreciate you worshiping tonight. Amen. We'll try to preach to you a little bit tonight. Amen. We will be judges. We want to be turning there. Amen. Judges. Amen. It's good to have Brother Birch with us. It's good to have Brother Cain with us tonight. Amen. Arkansas boys. Yeah. Play with Arkansas. Yeah. In whatever state you're in, you turn name things in, right? Yeah. I don't know if that's quite a mess. Judges, chapter 8. Praise the Lord. We begin reading Judges chapter 8, verse 1. Read to you some of the scriptures here and try to preach to you a little bit. Probably won't be preaching real long tonight. I just want to give you something that's on my heart. Amen. Verse 1, and the men of Ephraim said unto him, why hast thou served us thus? That thou callest us not when thou wentest to fight the Midianites. And David chided with him sharply. And he said unto them, what have I done now in comparison of you? Is not the gleaning of the grapes of Ephraim better than the vintage of Ephraim? And God hath delivered into your hand the princes of Midian, Orem, and Zeb. What was I able to do in comparison of you? Then their anger was abated toward him when he had said that. And Gideon came to Jordan and passed over, he and 300 men that were with him, faint, yet pursuing.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to preach from that last verse right there, verse 4. Faint, yet pursuing him.
Praise God.
Faint, yet pursuing him. Kind of, maybe the theme of this message might go a little bit along with what the choir was singing tonight. Amen. I would not take nothing for my journey now.
Amen.
Would not take nothing from my journey. Amen. Gideon has just won this tremendous battle. Gideon has just won a tremendous battle against the Midianites. You remember how the Gideon, he started off with a pretty good sized army, you know, something the man could be proud of. And remember how they said, okay, those that are fearful heart, you can go home. And all of a sudden, man, they started trying to walk away. And maybe Gideon, you know, probably, whoo. Wow, it's a little more than I expected. Then the Lord said, there's still too many. Gideon's probably, if he is mad, in his mind, I think we're probably, should have kept the ones we had. And then the Lord says, no, we're going to take them down to the brook, we're going to take them down to drink, and the one will get a drink, and those that laugh like a dog, we're going to dismiss those. And so, when it was all said and done, that nice big army that he had, the man could be proud of, was down to 300 men. Yes. 300 good men that didn't drink like dogs.
Right.
Alright?
That's about where they were.
Right.
300 good men. But you know how the Lord won the battle and how the fear came into the heart of the Midianites. And they fled before the 300 men. And as they were fleeing they were being pursued by Gideon's 300 men. Pursuing these Midianites and just winning a great victory that day and winning a great battle. And when they pursuing them, Gideon sends the people of Ephraim and tells them, go and catch them at the Jordan. Stop them at the Jordan. And so the people of Ephraim went. And they put up a block at the Jordan. They was able to catch the princes there. And it was a great victory that was won all the way around. Then when we get to chapter 8, verse 1, the two people of Ephraim are a little bit upset at Gideon because he didn't include them in the main fight.
Yeah.
And they was upset at him, and they was kind of, the Bible says they chided with him sharply. They were pretty upset at him for not including them and kind of, sometimes the way people act is why they're not included. You know? And maybe Gideon knew they was going to act like this. So why would you want to include them in the main, in the big deal, right? Yeah, sometimes this little rat trail. Sometimes if you feel like maybe that, you know what, you're being overlooked, or maybe that you're not being included, or maybe that, take a look inwardly. Okay? Do some self-inspection and see if maybe you could change yourself. Amen. All right? Because maybe Gideon was like, I knew it was coming. I knew it was coming. If you have to deal with the Ephraimites, you're going to get it. They're going to let you have it. So sure enough, they chided with him sharply. And so he had to deal with that situation. But let me get down to that verse. Faint, yet pursued.
Right.
I want you to notice that he grew faint. Let's look by the look at a couple things. He grew faint in the battle. Yeah. Right?
He did. Right.
And he grew faint with his brother. That's what I want to talk to you about.
Amen. Right?
Faint in the battle and faint with your brother.
Right. And
there's reasons to be faint. Now you would think Gideon, man, he's got the enemy on the run, and he's in a time of victory.
Yeah.
It is a time of victory.
Right.
And yet, still, he grows faint.
Yes.
He grows weary. He grows feeble. That word there that is used there in the Hebrew, it actually means to become feeble, to become idle, and to lack stamina. They had just lost their energy. They had lost their zeal for the fight. They were just going through the motions. They were faint, yet pursuing. They had grown faint. There's many times, amen, that we will grow faint. The Bible uses that word, faint, on many occasions when it talks about faint. And you can read throughout the Bible. The word faith begins to show itself and become clear. Remember what Isaiah said. What Isaiah said about those that would grow faint. Amen. They that he giveth power, Isaiah said in chapter 40, verse 29, he giveth power to the faint.
Amen.
Right.
He giveth power to the faint. It's not unusual. Right. Not unusual to faint. Remember that one of probably many of verses that you guys would remember, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
Amen.
They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, walk and not faint. Faint.
Amen.
Faint. And in the New Testament, we were reminded, amen, that we need to be careful not to faint.
Right.
That there is a possibility for us to faint. In Galatians chapter 6, and let us not be weary in well doing. For in due season we shall reap if we faint not. If we don't faint, there is a victory to be won. There is a blessing for us. Amen. Don't give up. Don't give up. Amen. Paul warned the Ephesians, wherefore I desire that ye faint not. That ye faint not. Amen. Be strong. Be careful. Because there is a tendency to grow weary and to faint.
Amen.
Yes. It's not unheard of, amen, for a Christian, amen, to begin to fall away and faint.
Right.
It's not unusual for a Christian to grow weary.
Right.
even in good times.
Right.
As Paul said, weary in well-doing.
Yes.
Weary in the midst of revival.
Right. Come on.
Weary in the midst of soul winning.
Right.
Weary in the midst of seeing God do something.
Right.
And weary when you're on top of everything.
Yes.
Weary. Wow, Elijah called fire down from heaven.
Amen.
So the heavens opened and rain poured out. And then it wasn't very long after that we find them running and hiding. We run and hide. Oh, Lord, and protect me. I'm the only one. Amen. This is becoming weary. Let me tell you what. Amen. Sometimes we will grow faint. Even in good times, even in victorious times, we need to be cautious of the faint.
Amen.
And there's some things that may cause us to faint. One of those things is the battle.
Amen.
Right.
It is the battle.
Right.
Do you just ever get tired?
Sure. Right.
Just get tired. Have you ever had a situation that you put up with and put up with and put up with until finally you get to the point where you say, I'm just tired.
Right. Right.
I'm weary of it.
Right.
I don't want to deal with it anymore. I'm done with it. You ever been there?
Right?
Right?
Sure.
Amen. Well, it's not your husband, your wife, your children. Maybe that's good. But I'm just weary of it. I'm weary of it. There's times that we go through the battle. We just get tired.
Yes.
We just get weary. And listen, Christians, you are in a battle.
Yes, we are.
Child of God, you're in a battle today.
Right.
You're in a battle for righteousness.
Yes.
You're in a battle against temptation.
Right.
Amen. You're in a battle against wickedness and evil.
Right.
Amen. You're in a battle every day. You fight and you struggle. You're in a battle with the weariness of life and the burdens of life.
Yes.
And the cares of this life. Amen. You live in a battle and you fight every day. This battle.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
And you just every day the attack on your mind.
Yeah.
The attack on your mind because you're battling against the evil. Amen. That would come against your mind. You battle against your thoughts. Battle against discouragement. Battle against depression. Battle against this. And all these things coming upon us.
Right. Amen.
That's easy sometimes, even in the midst of good times. Even in the midst of good times, then we just get weary. Listen, it wasn't that Gideon was losing the battle that made him faint.
No.
Right.
It was that he was winning the battle that made him faint.
Right.
It was the victory that he was winning that even made him grow faint.
Yes.
Amen. I know sometimes you feel like maybe you're faint because you're losing the battle. Amen. Many times it's because we're winning the battle. Listen, we put forth a lot of effort, a lot of energy, a lot of strength, amen, to win this battle.
Right.
And when you're fighting against evil, we tell you, praise God, that's a fight. It's a battle. And then, praise God, at the end of the day, when you overcome the battle, you overcome, you're victorious. Then you're weary.
Right.
You're faint.
Yes.
And that battle that we face, the battle against sin, battle against evil. Let me tell you, even while we're out trying to do something good for God, amen, there is a possibility of growing faint in our own life.
Right.
Growing faint in our own life.
Amen.
There's nothing I like more than to see people saved.
Right.
Nothing I like more than to see people at an altar pray.
Yes.
Nothing that I like more than to see God move. And the power of God. Tell you what, I love to preach and feel anointed and feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost and feel like God is touching somebody's life. I'll tell you what, that is a great joy.
Yes, it is.
But I'm telling you that when it's over with, I'll tell you, you don't know the weariness. Amen. How faint you feel. Amen. Because you feel like you have been fighting the forces of hell and fighting the enemy. Listen, amen. Then you can grow faint even in the battle. And Gideon here, he deals with it.
Sure.
He deals with it. And Paul knew what it was to grow faint with the brethren. Paul knew what it was. to have to deal with the church.
Right.
And the cares of the churches.
Right.
And to know that burden that was upon it. Yeah. Let me tell you what, it could make you grow faint dealing with your brother.
Sure. Right. Right.
This is supposed to be, man, we're supposed to be all having sweet fellowship. We're all supposed to have, you know, sweet unity. Oh, yes, we are. Yes, we are. But sometimes we get, you know, Here Gideon, he has to deal with some of the, while he's fighting an enemy.
Right.
He has to deal with the contention of his very own brethren.
Yes, he did. Right.
While he's fighting an enemy, pursuing an enemy, and trying to win a victory.
Yes.
And you know what? The victory that was going to be won was to their benefit.
Yes, it was.
It was going to benefit Ephraim as much as anybody.
Right.
It was going to be for their benefit. Everybody was going to be glad. But in the midst of the battle, in the midst of fighting the enemy, in the midst of victory,
yes,
they still chided him.
Right.
Sure.
Right.
Yes, they did.
They still had to take a jab.
Right.
They still had to stand up for their rights.
Yes.
They still had to let it be known that I'm not happy.
Yeah.
Boo. They wanted it to be known that, hey, this is, we feel like we've been done wrong.
Yeah.
In the middle of the battle, but listen, I know it's the case. I've seen him in the middle of good things where God's going to get ready to do good things.
Right.
I've seen brethren fall out.
Sure. Right.
I've seen brethren get sideways.
Right.
Yeah.
I've seen brethren get upset.
Yeah.
I've seen it happen in the church. And I tell you what, I've seen just when you're in the revival, and then you think the devil takes a vacation. Amen. When you're in youth camp, you think the devil takes vacation. Amen. When you're doing something good for God, amen, you think the devil takes vacation. Amen. When you're building something for the kingdom of God, amen, guess what? Amen. There's going to be contention.
Amen. Right.
Sometimes we can grow faint.
Yes.
Even with the prayer.
Yeah. Sure.
Right.
Even with the prayer.
Right.
Yeah, sometimes it can get that way.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
You can be down at the altar with your hands up. And you can be down there worshiping the Lord and rejoicing at what God is doing.
Right.
And while you're there, there's a tap on your shoulder.
Right.
This never happens. And if there's a tap on your shoulder while you're worshiping the Lord, while you're worshiping the Lord, there's a tap on your shoulder and you look over and someone got that look on their face thinking, oh boy, oh boy. I mean, they don't sometimes you don't even wait until you get a chance to get to the back door. Yes. Amen. Sometimes we can grow faint and weary.
Yeah.
I'm going on. There may be burdens that I'm carrying that maybe nobody else knows about. I may be battling some things in my life. I may be battling the enemy, but I want you to know, church, and that we are not about to give up.
No.
Pursue. Go on into victory. Amen. Go on into victory. Amen. Then what did I read to you in Isaiah chapter 40? He gave us strength to the faint. He gave us power to the faint.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. He is not. Amen. He has not given up. He giveth power to faith. Amen. To them that have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord, amen, shall renew their strength. Amen. They're not done yet in the battle. Amen. They'll renew their strength. They'll battle with wings as eagles. Amen. I like this. They will run and not be weary and walk and not faint. We're going to pursue on.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're going to pursue. Praise God. Be not weary in your well-doing.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. For a due season.
Yes.
Yes. Amen. You're going to reap.
Amen.
Amen. I know we like to focus on the faith, but man, focus on the harvest.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Man, I've never been so tired in my life. Forget about being tired. Look at me.
Yes.
Look at me.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Now I tell you what. Amen. These legs were not made for running. Okay? Now my brother Danny, he was a runner.
Yeah.
He could run. He could run long distance runner. He could do that. Amen. They always said, and they always, you know, we tend to bring it over here. And we did a cross-country run, you know, and I forget how mile and a half, 2 miles, whatever it was. And we had to do it at a certain time. And the guys like Danny would always say to us, Jerry, you know, that second win. Man, there's kind of a, where's that? Where's, I can use a second win, you know? I mean, I need some win, but I mean, they would describe it as something that just kicks in, you know, and it just like takes over. And I'm like, I fall across the finish line and I'm dying. And I'm like, we are one second wind. I really think it was a big joke, a big put on. There is no such thing. But no, there really is for a runner. And they know that second wind kicks in, whether you're a runner, and it hasn't been a runner. And then that second wind kicks in, and man, you can. Just keep going.
Yes. Yeah.
Keep going.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
You made me think about the time I had been sitting at Burger King eating a Whopper. And I look out the window and here goes Brother Rob running down the street. Okay, he's out running. And I'm like, wow. Oh, Brother Rob. Yes. Amen. I was for him 100%. I sure hope his second win kicked in about the time my second Whopper did. Amen. I'm telling you. Amen. Woo.
Amen.
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 Yeah, they said talk about that second win. I mean, I think that's where Gideon, amen, something kicked in. I'm faint.
Yeah.
But I'm not ready to give up.
Right.
Amen. I'm going to pursue.
Amen.
I'm going to pursue until I have victory.
Praise God. Praise God.
Until I have victory.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He was faint in the battle. Do you know what? He was pursuing that victory that was there.
He was.
Notice something else. His brethren.
Right.
Gideon, you know what he did? He took the low road.
Yeah.
Look what it says about Gideon in chapter 8 when they chided him sharply. Okay? He said to them, what have I done now in comparison to you? Man, what he says, I haven't done anything compared to you. Man, you guys really have won the victory. You guys, he was willing to give them the credit.
Right.
Willing to give them, he said, man, you captured the princes.
Right.
Man, look what you've captured. Look what you've done. I've done nothing compared to what you guys have done. You know what I see there? I see him pursuing peace and unity with his brethren. Amen. Even though, amen, it may have hurt, and even though he may have made him weary, having to deal with it, faint, having to deal with it, amen, he took, he turned away wrath by giving a soft answer. Amen. He pursued peace and unity. Amen. Follow after peace with all men. And that's what Hebrews tells us. Amen. Pursue that with all your heart.
Amen.
Pursue that.
I believe it.
And I'll tell you what, the victory's worth it.
Right. Amen.
It's the unity of the brethren is worth pursuing.
Yes, it is. Amen.
Amen. I can't believe they spoke to me like that. And you know what you say to yourself? That's all right. You don't deserve to be spoken to me better than that. Don't they know who I am? Apparently not. But just tell them. Just say to yourself, you know what? It's all right. I'm nobody.
Yeah.
I'm nobody.
That's right.
Pursue that peace and pursue that unity with the brethren.
Right.
Amen. You know why? You know why he was doing this? He was realizing the victory is more important.
Yes.
Amen. Than the division. Amen. Between the brethren. Amen. Why would we want to start a civil war? Amen. Before we even finish and get the victory over the battle we're in right now. Somebody may say something, somebody may hurt you, somebody may do something, but I want you, amen, faith, pursue peace, pursue unity, amen, for the sake of the victory, amen, for the sake of the battle, amen, for sake of winning and coming out victorious, amen, don't put yourself up too high, amen, turn away wrath with a soft answer, amen, humble yourself, amen, and say, oh, it's all for the good of God and the work of the Lord. Sometimes jealousy,
sure.
Envy, pride.
Right.
Yeah, that's sometimes that's the source of most contention.
Yes.
And just humble yourself.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. Amen.
Pursue that peace.
Every way, Lord.
Yeah.
Every way, Jesus.
Pursue unity.
Right. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Before you get your feelings hurt. Why don't you just stop it right there and say, you know what, they really didn't mean it that way.
Yeah. Right.
Before you get your feelings hurt, why don't you say something like, you know, they're probably going through something. They're probably dealing with something in their own life.
Right.
Now before you get your feelings hurt, then you know what you ought to do?
Right.
Yeah. Pray for your brother.
Yeah.
Lord, I don't know what they're going through. I don't know what they're dealing with. God, if I've done anything, I'm sorry. Lord, help me be a strength to my brother.
Amen. Right.
Help me be a blessing to my brother.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Please, God, have a chocolate cake in his life. Hallelujah. Be a blessing. Because you know why? Even though we may grow faint, there's something, there's a greater cause here. There's a great cross.
Amen.
Amen.
It's the victory.
Such a great cross. Amen. Yes, there is. That's it.
It's the victory.
Amen. That's the truth.
The greater cause.
Hallelujah.
Amen. His soul saved.
Yes.
Tell you what. Just talking to you tonight, all right?
Just talking.
Man, I know how things happen. I know how things happen. There's a greater cause.
Amen.
On your bus, in your children's church group, there's a greater cause.
Amen.
That's right.
Yes.
Maybe you get the seat you wanted on the bus. Maybe somebody else took your door position. You know, whatever. But there's a greater cause. That greater cause is the soul trying to reach for the kingdom of God.
Yes.
And the work of the Lord. Maybe, guess what? Maybe you didn't get the starring role in the children's church skit this time. Alright? Maybe you didn't get it. But guess what? There's a greater cause. And that is that those kids than hear the message of Jesus Christ?
Yes, it is. Right.
Hallelujah. Maybe you didn't get asked to sing. But there's a greater cause.
Right.
And that is that people might be touched by the one that is singing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
Amen. When you're not able to lead the singing, Brother Ryan, amen.
Right.
I can get put anywhere, Jesus. I had to get off the ground. But I'm not going to do that. Just make it a point. Get in there and say, hey, man. Praise God.
That's it.
There's a greater cause.
Amen. Praise God.
There's a greater cause.
Hallelujah.
Stand with me. Lord.
Praise God. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What? There's many times we profane.
Yes.
The battle with the brethren. But oh God.
Hallelujah.
And I'm not about to give up.
Amen. No way.
I'm not about to give up.
Right.
And then I'm going to pursue till we have complete victory.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And why do we need to stop pursuing the real end?
Yes. Amen.
To contend with.
Hallelujah.
Our imaginary. Right?
Amen.
Man, tell you what, there's times, and you know this to be true, we can get sideways with one another, get upset, kill revival, kill a service.
Yeah.
Then when we finally get together and talk about it, it's all just miscommunication anyway.
Right, right.
I'm like, what?
Right.
Really? That's a great cause. That's a great cause. Lord Jesus, I thank you, God, for the privilege we have, Lord God, to serve you, to live for you, God. I thank you, God, for the privilege we have to be a part of this great church. God, I thank you, Lord Jesus, God, for the ministries and the callings that you've placed in this congregation. I thank you, Lord Jesus, God, that you've equipped, God, the people of Bethel Chapel, God, to accomplish great things and to do great things and to work and labor for you, Lord. And God, I thank you, Lord Jesus, God, for the privilege and opportunity we have, Lord God, to reach souls every week, to touch somebody, to reach out to people every week, to have an opportunity to pour into somebody's life. And God, we thank you for that opportunity. God, I pray, Lord, that you would help us to gain the victory. God, and while, Lord, we may grow faint and weary. Lord, while we may grow weary in the process. God, we may grow weary in the labor, Lord God, and in the work. God, I pray, Lord God, that you help us. Keep pursuing, Lord. God, keep pursuing. Lord, peace and unity among our brethren. Keep pursuing the victory, Lord. God, the ultimate victory, the complete victory. God, we give you praise and glory for what you do in our life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let me ask you tonight. Amen. Isn't it true that you're glad, amen, to be a part of what God is doing? Aren't you glad? And isn't it a privilege? Isn't it a privilege to be able to play a role in reaching somebody for Christ? Hallelujah. Isn't it a privilege to be part of the church and have the opportunity to reach somebody for Christ and touch lives? Amen. It's a great opportunity and privilege. Amen. I know sometimes we get weary. I know sometimes we get hurt. Hallelujah. Here's something that stood out to me that I'm going to cover the altar. How many men did Gideon have when he left the brook? Somebody tell me. 300. He just attacked an army that they they said looked like grasshoppers.
Yeah.
There were so many. Camels that were so many they could not be numbered. I mean, this was a huge army. And when we see him faint yet pursuing, how many does it say he has? 300.
Right.
And you can still strengthen one another. And when one is faint, you can encourage them.